President, and I just wanted to also thank Senator Larkin and all of the colleagues, all of our colleagues here for supporting this really important resolution. And, you know, growing up, one of the things that interests me, and I'm not sure why, but I've always been so interested in World War II history. I've studied it a great deal. I have a pretty extensive library of books on the subject. I even had the good fortune in the 1990s of traveling to London, and I visited the Imperial War Museum, where you're able to see firsthand so much of the machinery that was used during this conflict. And even in Hollywood, you know, there were a number of really good movies that in many ways accurately depicted, or as close as possible, what was going on during that time. I think of Saving Private Ryan and The Longest Day, and there were many other movies. And of course, it is Hollywood, but throughout all of that, there is some bit of reality as to what soldiers were dealing with. And World War II was so much more than just a war. It was really a struggle for the human race. It was really so much a turning point for humanity. The conflict and how the United States entered into that conflict at a time where things seemed insurmountable. And soldiers, many of who are represented here, who were willing to sort of disrupt their lives, not just for that moment, but for the rest of their lives, to enter into a conflict to fight against the evils of tyranny. People like myself, okay, born in the 1970s, never having lived through that conflict, only reading about it and hearing about it from those who are older than me, I empathize so deeply with how incredible that struggle must have been and the burden. Things that I took for granted when I was in my early 20s, you know, being in college, hanging out with my friends. Well, that generation in the 1940s were wondering if they were going to be on a ship the next morning, if they were going to be on a beach fighting for their lives. And they knew that the reality was that many of them would not be coming home. The psychological effect that that has, not only at that present moment, but something that they carry with them throughout their lives. My fear is that as generations come and go, that we forget, that we will forget what happened. And that's why I think it's wonderful that that display is down in the LOB. And when I saw it, I got so excited and took a lot of photos because this wasn't Hollywood, this was real. Those bullets were real. The cloud of tyranny over Europe was getting closer to our shores. A lot of people don't realize that there were U-boats up and down the coast of the United States, and they were attacking our ships and attacking our harbors. And that on the Pacific front, the Axis forces were doing tremendous harm and damage at Pearl Harbor and in other places. This was truly a global conflict, and it was squeezing everything that was so important about the United States and why we stood for the things that we stood for. So when I hear a resolution like today, I want Colonel Larkin to know that the lessons have not been lost on my generation, if I have anything to do with it, because I think that this is something that we must never lose our vigilance on. The same battles that the soldiers who were fighting in World War II, that evil is not gone forever. It can return at any given moment. And we can't be complacent, and we always have to be vigilant and stand up against injustice in any form, stand up against bigotry and racism and the totalitarian tyranny that we saw that sort of grew in the 1930s and 40s throughout Europe. So I thank Colonel Larkin, Senator Larkin, and my colleagues for bringing this resolution, and I hope that we do continue to teach this lesson, that it be accurately taught to future generations in schools, to know that the sacrifices that were made for the freedoms that we take for granted this day and age. Thank you.